Hi everyone, it's Corinne here at Hairstring doing another video of the Brazilian knot extension. So today I'm doing a full head and I am not leaving a lot of hair out. So as you can see, the hair that I'm braiding is all that would be out. I'm going to start with the first, actually before I start talking about the first row, let me first describe the hair that we started with. This client is natural, so there is no chemical treatment on her hair. So she doesn't have a relaxer or a Brazilian blowout. So what I did is I shampooed, blow dried her hair, and I flat ironed it. So when her hair is flat ironed, this is what it looked like. I'm going to post a picture of her hair before the flat iron, so that you see what I started with after the second row. So here's a picture. Her hair is natural, washed and blow dried and flat ironed. All right, so continuing on with the second row. So like I was saying, I am doing a full head, so there will be very little hair out for coverage because it's a full head, so the coverage is pretty minimal. So you have an option of not leaving any hair at all out. So since her hair is extremely curly, as you saw at the beginning, I left a little bit out so that when she washes it and flat iron a little bit, she doesn't have to make it completely straight. It will give her a lot of coverage, believe it or not. This video all in total is about 22 minutes. So I'm, fast forwarding everything because it's pretty much the same thing. I'm just wrapping the thread around the hair over and over and over till I get to the top. So the section are pretty much a standard size section. If you want to, have them done smaller, of course I can do them smaller. It will take much, much longer to achieve a full head. But that can be done. I've done it before. I just never, filmed it. Because that would be like all day thing trying to film Brazilian knots smaller than what you're seeing right now. I know a lot of you will have questions about the texture of her hair and when she washes it, how it would look. So when she shampoos her hair, it will pretty much go back to her curly texture. So what she'll have to do is she'll have to separate each one of the knots and flat iron her natural hair, like kind of stretch it out and flat iron it or blow dry it, and then braid the entire Brazilian knot and wear the hair wavy. So that's an option if you don't want to do all of that, because it is a little bit of maintenance. If you choose not to do a Brazilian blowout or a relaxer, you'll have to do a lot more work as far as maintenance. But say your hair is relaxed and it looked exactly as you see that way, there isn't much you have to do. All you have to do is, shampoo, blow dry your hair, curl it however you want, or braid it and wear it wavy. If you choose to do a Brazilian blowout, which is another option, it's pretty awesome for those who have natural curly hair. You will get the Brazilian treatment and your Brazilian knot the same day. You can do that. Have it done the same day. And when you shampoo your hair, your texture is actually manageable. So all you have to do is blow dry and you go. So this will last you 3 to 4 months. Now, I know I've seen some places where they say the Brazilian knots will last you 6 months. Oof, that's a lot. 6 months with hair extension, you really shouldn't do that. 2 to 3 months is healthy. 4 months is pushing it. Something came up. You just have other things to do and you just can't make it to the salon. 4 months is okay, but I wouldn't push it to 4.5 months or 5 months. 6 months is, that's just going way too far. You'll see a lot of shedding. Let's see, what else can I cover? With the Brazilian blowout, if you get the Brazilian blowout treatment with the Brazilian knot, that is the only time you have to use those sulfate-free shampoo to make sure that you're keeping the keratin in your hair. But the Brazilian knot extension itself doesn't require a special shampoo. You can use whatever type of shampoo you've been using before. It doesn't require you to change your hair regimen. So that's not an issue. As far as flat iron and curling your hair, it's the same thing as long as you don't touch the knot at the roots, because you want to keep your knots in together. As you can see, the thread is elastic, it stretches, it's very strong, but it cannot handle the heat of an iron. So do not put the flat iron right on top of it when you're curling or flat iron your hair. You can oil your scalp. If you have dry scalp during your time with the Brazilian knot, I know certain keratin extension, like if you're doing the fusion, you cannot oil your scalp because the bonding agent does not handle oil. So that's one thing you don't have to worry about the Brazilian knot, is that you can use whatever product you want to use on your hair pretty much. If you need to color your roots, you can color your roots. If you need to do a relaxer touch-up, you can do that. What I will always say about chemical services during your wear of the Brazilian knot is that you rinse it out thoroughly. And when I mean rinsing, if you normally rinse your hair for like, let's say 30 seconds or a minute, I would say double or triple that time and go section by section. Make sure you get all that product out so it doesn't get stuck into the knots. Let's see, what else can I cover? So her hair took me about 6 hours to do, because that's a full head. So I'm on this video is broken down into two videos. So this is the first one. So I think this video stopped halfway through. And then the next one would be, you know, finishing the top and curling and all of that. So this one took me about 6 hours. We started at 8 o'clock and we finished at about 2, so 8 to 9 o'clock was shampooing, blow drying, and flat ironing the hair. And then from 9 to 2 was pretty much the service, you know, the Brazilian knots, cut and curl. So for those with curly hair who want to get curly extensions, I don't always carry curly hair at the salon, because it's just difficult to match everyone's curl pattern. So you are allowed to bring your own hair. So if you do decide to go with curly hair, make sure that it is hair that matches your texture. That way when you wash it, you wash your hair, you don't have to worry about trying to curl it to blend it. There are a lot of companies out there that sell variety of curl pattern that will make it easy for you to match. Can you get the Brazilian knot if you've never gotten them done before? I say yes, but everyone is different. Every texture is different, so it's different for everyone. One way to know if you will be a good candidate for the Brazilian knot, kind of figure that out, you know, recently, just, you know, trying different texture. If you've had braids before, it's pretty much the same thing, you know, the sectioning, and it's just less work than getting braids done. So if you've had braids before, you can definitely get the Brazilian knot. If you've never had braids before and you want to try the Brazilian knot because you've had other extensions before, I would not suggest that you do a full head right away. I would say something partial, like 3 to 4 rows. And I can make 4 rows look very full, like you have an entire head. You'd start with 3 to 4 rows, and then you see how your hair handles it for like 2 months. And then you can do a full head the next time if you've never had the Brazilian knot done. That's a way to ease your way into it, kind of figure out if that's something that will work for you. So as far as, you know, having your hair done by me, you know, I have packages that include the hair and you know, it comes in different length and different texture. I normally use Indian or raw Cambodian hair. Indian hair will be raw as well. I don't use Brazilian hair. So if you want to get your Brazilian knot with Brazilian hair, that's fine. I always suggest that you get hair that is great quality, because all of your hair is out with the extension. You don't want hair that you're not familiar with. So if it's something that you're familiar with, you're comfortable with using, that's fine. Bring it in. I don't have a problem with using the hair that you want. I ask that you don't bring any old hair. If it is old hair, it needs to be shampooed, clean, and smelling fresh. That would take, you know, less time for me to have to sort them out and clean them for you. And I will charge for that. So you can bring your own hair, use or not, just let it be clean and sorted into the length that you want me to start with. So if you bring in like two or three different lengths, you want to put them in three different bags, label in the length that you want, that you have, and that you want me to put in. So if you want the 16 in the bag, 14 in the middle, 12 on top, you would just let me know where they're going. But as long as the hair is clean and separated, then it's cool. My prices are on my website. There is no, you know, hidden thing. Everything is there on the website. If it's not there, then it's not a service that I do all the time. But if it's something that I do all the time and the price isn't there, more than likely I'm charging by the hour. When we're doing Brazilian knots, I have different prices for the Brazilian knot. But if your service go over 8 hours, meaning I'm doing them extremely small, they go over 8 hours, you're paying a daily rate. So you'll see what the daily rate is on my website. Usually a full head such as this one that we're watching now, something like that may take someone else an entire day. I work pretty fast. I've been doing the Brazilian knot since late 2009, so I'm pretty used to it. I can do a full head within 8 hours, but if I go over 8 hours, it's a full daily rate. It does take a long time. It's tiring. So when you come in, come ready, and I will go as fast as I can, and we keep the prices as you know what you know. But if it takes a long time because you choose to change the style, you want something smaller because you want it to look a different way, that's fine. We can do that. But I would prefer that we kind of discuss that ahead of time so there's no surprises. So the prices are on the website. You can bring your own hair. I can give you references and of where you can go purchase hair at. If you're in LA, there are a few places that I know where you can get hair if I don't have the hair that you're looking for. If you're coming in from out of town, I can try to help you as well. Yes, I do have people who come from out of town to get their hair done out of the country as well. I can travel to you, or you can come to me, and we can work out those details. So you just let me know ahead of time. So we're pretty much close to the end of this video. So I'm just going to let you watch, and I'll see you in the next one. Oh, and before I go, if you have any questions, you can comment below the video. I will post this video on Instagram, Facebook, and YouTube. So any of those social media comments, you can just leave your questions or whatever, and I will get back to you on it, or I will answer your question in the following video. All right, take care and have a wonderful day.
see him move. Ride with me, ride with me, boss. I got a hard head, but her arrow tall. She wants the last name with the ring on it, cause I pulled out a million.